Hi, my name is Daniel. I'm the director of Cayman Management Consultants. In this segment, we attempt to answer the questions, commonly asked questions for immigration and company incorporation or corporate matters, right? So if you're ready, let's go on to today's question. Okay, company address. Now, this is actually a fairly straightforward question, but actually there's a lot of complications. Now, the complication comes because not a lot of people work from home. So by right, your address of the office is at home. But just to let you know, for example, if you are local, right, you cannot use your HDB address as a commercial address. By law, it's illegal, but people still do it. And, you know, so far, no one, if you don't get caught, you know, no problem, all right? But yeah, by right, you need to use a commercial address for your address. Now, what's the repercussions of, let's say, for example, if I have a condo, can I use my condo, right? It's a private property. The answer is still actually not, you're not supposed to, but a lot of people do it, right? By right, if you are using your home as a commercial address, your utilities will also change to be a commercial utility. Your broadband will be now a commercial price broadband, but you know, who's gonna do that, right? So just, you know, to be very clear to you, you cannot use your residential address for your commercial address. However, what there are many solutions, right? Now, with a lot of co-working spaces, you can actually approach any co-working space, you know, and you know, they can provide you an address, right, for as low as $150 to $200 a year. So using that address is, I think, a more wiser choice. In addition to that, actually, if you have an address, let's say, for example, in Orchard Road, right, I mean, people will look at your address in your company and they say, hey, you know, that company has an address in Orchard Road. Shouldn't be too a shady company, right? As compared if your address is Block 95, Kim Kiat Road, you know, no offense to those people who stay in Kim Kiat Road, but I just say out the address, but, you know, people will know that that is just a home address. So unless you want to portray yourself as a small business or home business, then I would suggest you to get a commercial address. Now, another thing that the company secretary can do in a previous video is also to provide the address, right? So you can also ask them for the address and, you know, they will charge you a small fee for it. Now, as I said earlier, if you are a home-based business, then, well, you have no choice, but you have to inform HDB or, you know, your condo that you're going to use the address for your home-based business. So that's the most clear-cut way of, having your address legalized. One last thing about addresses, though, important for all my foreign friends here, is that if your address is, for example, an address that is at home or it's just a vested address of an accountant, it wouldn't be too good because sometimes M1 will ask you where's your place of work. And if your place of work is at the accountant's place or the copsec's place or at, you know, home, usually they don't want to approve your passes. Just to let you know. So for, especially for foreigners, you know, if you want to set up a company, if a company you want to apply an EP, please get a commercial address. So that's all for today's question. If you have any questions that you might want to know regarding incorporation or immigration, do let us know through our various social media somewhere over here that, you know, my team's going to put inside. And yeah, looking forward to seeing you in the next video.